Hey guys, thanks for checking in with STTOP. Today, we're rethinking recycling. I don't expect you to go like a year without creating any waste or anything like that, but I do have a question. Are you a collector? And I don't mean of things like dolls that remind you of Taylor Swift. I'm talking about, are you a collector of stuff like tennis balls? I have tennis balls, broken tennis balls, because I have a scarily powerful backhand and for no other reason. I thought instead of throwing them out, I could turn them into keychain holders. This one has googly eyes on it. Impressive, right? But what do we do with all the rubbish we accumulate? For every human on Earth, there is 1 ton of plastic. In 2017 to 2018, Australians used 3.4 million tons of plastic. Of that, only 9% was recycled. At this rate, by 2050, there'll be more plastic in the sea than fish. And how do I know this? Lottie told me. And who's Lottie? A zero waste expert and founder of Banish. Lottie DL is all about transforming stuff, just like me. Lottie, we're basically the same person, right? You take old bottle caps and turn them into pens, and I turn tennis balls into keychain holders.
Yeah, it's not really quite the same thing. I get other people's waste to recycle.
So people send you their rubbish?
They send me their recycling in the mail. They literally post it to Brad. Then we have an amazing team of volunteers who come in and sort it into the different waste streams. And then they're sent on to different Australian recyclers to be recycled. So all of these items that would have just gone to landfill can now have another use.
Tell me about Brad.
So BRAD stands for the Banish Recycling and Disposal Program, which recycles those hard to recycle household items like blister packs, beauty products, coffee pods. BRAD is a service, so it costs $15 to send us approximately about a shoebox or 3 kilos worth of your hard to recycle items back to us. But when we receive that box, we actually give you a $15 voucher to spend in the store at Banish.
So what are you going to turn my next toothbrush into?
So your toothbrush will go into things like building materials, your coffee cups will go into the bumpers in parking lots.
You're saying that my toothbrush will end up in building somewhere?
Exactly, strong and sturdy.
In 1950, the world produced only 2 million tons of plastic per year. Since then, annual production has increased nearly 230 times. Now I get it, all right? I hear stats all the time and they kind of just bounce off my brain. So, how about an analogy? Say you have a babysitting gig, right? You're gonna babysit 2 kids. Oh, so easy, right? But you rock up and it turns out the parents have talked to everyone in their lives, everyone they know, all their friends and family, and they say, hey, do you mind if we actually get you to babysit 460 kids? Because that's the scale. And they just go, have a good night, good luck. You panic, right? I would, you know, I'd panic being around one child, but that's what the earth is doing, panicking. What would you say is the most damaging kind of waste?
Probably be things like microplastics. Things like when you use a tea bag, for example, it's estimated that 11 billion pieces of microplastics break off and fragment in that one cup of tea. So they're just going to go straight down our waterways. And then ultimately, we're probably going to ingest them in the future.
11 billion from one tea bag.
Majority of the supermarket branded tea bags are the ones that contain plastics.
Thank you so much, Lottie. I have learned a ridiculous amount from this. I really appreciate it.
Thanks, Matt.
Okay, so what are we doing? We're recycling those hard to dispose of plastics. Mine is going to be full of my old toothpaste tubes, my floss containers, and my toothbrushes. There are next level recycling companies all over the place. Lottie's Brad is in Sydney. Find your Brad. If you want to share your progress, you can use the hashtag #Stop2030 or #RethinkingRecycling. Post a list of what you plan to recycle. I want to know.